In this 21st Sunday of Ordinary Time Year B, we are back to the readings for the Gospel of St. John, chapter 6. Now, as you recall, I've mentioned numerous times before that John chapter 6 is about the Holy Eucharist. It presents a very beautiful theology that captures the essence of what the Holy Eucharist is all about. And many scholars label this chapter, John chapter 6, as the Bread of Life discourse, and some only consider that starting in verse 22 to the end of the chapter. In any case, John chapter 6 is about the Holy Eucharist, the body and blood of Jesus Christ. Now, notice how this year is a little different since the solemnity of the Assumption of the Blessed Virgin Mary into heavenly glory falls on a Sunday this year in 2021. This is a significant solemnity that it even replaces the Sunday celebration. Now, if you are interested in the reflection on the Feast of the Assumption of the Blessed Virgin Mary, you can find it on my YouTube channel here. I posted that last week. Here, though, we are going back to the Sunday Gospel reading, and this Sunday is the last reading from the Gospel of St. John, chapter 6. So everything, in other words, culminate in this very last passage. Notice, this is the last passage. When the disciples who have been following Jesus for all this time have to make a very, very, very important decision that will impact their lives forever. Take a look at verse 66, for example, and you'll know exactly what I mean. Here's what it says. As a result of this, many of his disciples returned to their former way of life and no longer accompanied him. Okay, so then in this 21st Sunday in Ordinary Time Year B, from the Gospel of St. John, chapter 6, verses 60 to 69, I'd like to share three important points for us to focus on and to reflect further in this Gospel reading. Number one, the continued dialogue back and forth between Jesus and the crowd. And, you know, those who have followed my reflections for John chapter 16 these past several weeks, I've been emphasizing this point, that is the dialogue between Jesus and the crowd. So then you have the people following Jesus all the time, and now it's their turn to make a decision. It's their turn to figure out if they will continue to follow Jesus or if they will instead return to their former way of life. Think about the last time you had to make an important decision in your life. It could be any important decision. Maybe it's deciding what college you will attend. Or maybe it's deciding what city you are going to move to, or what job you're going to sign up for and what job you're going to do. Or maybe it's deciding what house you're going to buy, or perhaps something extremely important for most people, who you're going to marry and to spend the rest of your life with, right? You see, many of us have important decisions we must make in our life. And before making this important decision, we normally think about it. We normally weigh the good, the bad, the pros and the cons. And then after some time of thinking, we make a decision one way or another, and of course, always hoping for the best. Now, I share this point because if you really read the gospel passage for this Sunday in particular, you'll see many of the followers of Jesus also have to make an important decision here. Should they continue and follow Jesus, or should they just leave Jesus and return to their former way of life? You can see this part of the passage really clearly. Now, here's the reality. Jesus makes his point clear. He says, I am the bread of life. And here's what the Gospel of John says. Many of Jesus' disciples who were listening said, this saying is hard. Who can accept it? Well, that's right. This saying is hard. Who can accept it? How can Jesus be the bread that come down from heaven? For many, this makes no sense to them. And further, how John develops this point in the gospel, we can see. Here's what he says. Then Jesus tells them, since Jesus knew that his disciples were murmuring about this, he said to them, Does this shock you? What if you were to see the Son of Man ascending to where he was before? That's an important question to think about. Does this shock you? Does it shock you that Jesus is the true bread of life? Apparently, from among the crowd that is following Jesus, it is shocking to many of them. And so what it comes down to is the idea of faith, that is belief, which then brings me to the second point I'd like to share here, and it's this: belief as the key to understanding this passage in the Gospel of John chapter 6. And in fact, belief is the key to understanding the whole Gospel of St. John the Evangelist. You'll notice in many passages how St. John sneaks in the word belief or faith here and there. Now read through pretty much any chapter of John's Gospel and you'll know what I mean. Think about the most popular passage of all time in John chapter 3, verse 16. Here's what it says: "For God so loved the world that he gave his only Son, so that everyone who believes in him might not perish, but might have eternal life." Or another well-known passage in the Gospel of John, chapter 11, verse 25 to 26. This is often used at funerals. Here's what it says: Jesus says, "I am the resurrection and the life. Whoever believes in me, even if he dies, will live. And everyone who lives and believes in me will never die. Do you believe this?" Now notice the word belief used in two different ways. There are tons more passages with the word faith and belief that is used throughout the Gospel of John. But here's the point. Just like these other passages, the one we are reading for this Sunday, that is John chapter 6 verses 60 to 69, emphasizes the word faith and belief. In this passage in particular, the followers now have to decide. They will have to make a decision on whether they will continue to follow Jesus or whether they will leave Jesus. And the decision, one way or another, is all about belief. It's all about faith. Which then brings me to the third and final point I'd like to share in this passage here. And it's this: we all have the free will to decide to follow Jesus or to not follow Jesus. We have the free will to decide. And as I mentioned before, all the followers of Jesus ultimately have to make a decision. Should they continue with Jesus or should they return to their former way of life? Here's what the gospel passage says. Jesus knew from the beginning the ones who would not believe and the one who would betray him. And he said, "For this reason, I have told you that no one can come to me unless it is granted him by my Father." And as a result of this, many of his disciples returned to their former way of life and no longer accompanied him. Friends, here's the point. Jesus freely allowed his followers to decide to follow him or to leave him. And you'll also notice in John's gospel, many have decided to no longer follow Jesus and instead return to their former way of life. But notice that Jesus does not stop them. He didn't say, hey, come back. Or he didn't say anything or do anything to try to entice them to stay, to remain, to not go away. You see, Jesus plainly spoke the truth. And then he let the followers decide whether they want to continue or to leave. Jesus speaks the truth. And sometimes the truth is very difficult, right, to understand, to comprehend. And so it takes faith and it takes belief, you see. Now notice how Jesus turns to his own close group of disciples, that is the 12. Here's what the gospel says. Jesus then said to the 12, "Do you also want to leave?" And pay attention to this beautiful response from Peter. "Master, to whom shall we go? You have the words of eternal life. We have come to believe and are convinced that you are the Holy One of God." And so here's the main point. Here's the main point. All of us are searching for the truth in this life. And we are searching for the truth in different places. But in the end, it is Jesus we are searching for. And then it's up to us whether or not we are willing to continue to follow Jesus in our life. You see, God gives us the free will to choose. He allows us to do whatever it is we want to do with our life. But in the end, it is Jesus that will find that in Jesus that we'll find the most meaning, significance in our life. Jesus is the truth. And so, dear friends, the Gospel of John 6 is above all an important reminder for all of us about the Holy Eucharist, true bread from heaven, the body and blood of Jesus Christ. And then also too, at the end here, as you can see, the free will for every one of us to choose and to decide whether we want to follow Jesus or not. So consider this important question for your further reflection. Now, just imagine yourself being part of the crowd in the Gospel of John 6. You now have to decide, are you going to follow Jesus? Are you going to continue? Or are you going to return to your former way of life and go search for something else? Think about this. May God bless you.